You probably already know éclair au chocolat, macarons, tartelettes, and you know that food is at the center of French culture. Les pâtisseries that you can see around me are delicious. It's a fantastic way to familiarize yourself with French culture as well. Why not? Today, let's discover three of them together. Before we start, a warning for lots of students who don't know that une pâtisserie, as you can see here, is not une viennoiserie. Une viennoiserie is un croissant, un pain au chocolat, un chausson aux pommes, all these kind of things. We'll cover it in another lesson, but today it's all about une pâtisserie that you can see here. As usual, this lesson comes with a free written lesson in PDF that you can get for free on cominfrancaise.com. There you have vocabulary, you have links, you have extra resources. You can print the PDF, keep it forever, take notes on it, highlight the words that you want to remember, and even share it with your friends if you want. Also, you have a free email in French about the lesson every Tuesday if you're a subscriber of my newsletter to help you practice your reading skills in French. Check it out, it's completely free. How can you get them? If you're on YouTube, go to the link below the video and you will get access to Comme une Française. There, click on the button below the lesson and leave your first name and email to get them straight away. And again, both are completely free. Bonjour, c'est Géraldine. It smells so good today. Bienvenue sur Comme une Française. C'est parti. Let's learn some French today and then eat everything. Our first pâtisserie for today is un éclair au chocolat. It's this one. Un éclair au chocolat. I hope you can see it properly. I will probably take a picture and show it to you. Un éclair au chocolat. So good. The outside of un éclair au chocolat is la pâte à choux. La pâte à choux is everything that's outside. La pâte à choux, and inside you have la crème pâtissière. La crème pâtissière is the filling of un éclair au chocolat. Un éclair au chocolat, inside you have la crème pâtissière. Obviously, in un éclair au chocolat, la crème pâtissière is with chocolates. And then on the top you have le glaçage. And le glaçage applies to other pâtisseries as well, like this one and this one. Le glaçage is at the top. Le glaçage. This one is un éclair au chocolat, but you can also have un éclair au café, with coffee, un éclair au café. You can have un éclair à la vanille, un éclair à la vanille, and lots of other tastes, but these three are the main ones. If you know a brand about l'éclair, it might be l'éclair de génie. L'éclair de génie, they're very, very, very creative with their éclair, and they're delicious. I highly recommend you check them out if you're in Paris or in France. And also in any good pâtisserie, you'll find fantastic éclairs. Our second contestant for today is la tartelette. That's une tartelette. Can I show it to you without folding it down? I will again take a picture. Une tartelette. Une tartelette is une petite tarte, actually. Une tartelette is une petite tarte. We add the et at the end to make it sound smaller. Une tartelette. Here it's une tartelette au citron. So at the bottom you have une pâte sablée. It's the crust, the sweet short crust pastry. La pâte sablée. And you don't necessarily have une tartelette au citron. You can have une tartelette aux framboises. Une tartelette aux framboises. You can have une tartelette au citron meringué. So that's with meringue on the top. I didn't pick this one for today because you would not see the lemon. So that was better. Une tartelette au citron meringué. Delicious. Une tartelette au chocolat. That's with chocolate. Easy. Une tartelette au chocolat. As you can notice in what I just mentioned, une tartelette aux framboises has an S, but une tartelette au citron and une tartelette au chocolat does not. Because it's the taste, it's not the number of fruits on it. So, une tartelette aux framboises, you have several framboises on the top. But une tartelette au citron, it's the taste of lemon. Une tartelette au chocolat, it's the taste of chocolate. You can also have une tartelette aux fraises, very famous. And if you live in Grenoble, you have une tartelette aux noix. La tarte aux noix is a very famous specialty from where I live. Une tartelette aux noix, because walnuts are a specialty of Grenoble. If you love French food, not just les pâtisseries, and more wine, bread, and the cheese, which are delicious, you should check out Inside of French. It's my program that is all about teaching you spoken French using food. So I give you lectures on food and you can practice your oral comprehension. So you learn culture, manners, vocabulary, and you improve your oral comprehension. It's very interesting. I loved making this course for you. And our third pâtisserie for today is le millefeuille. Let me get it for you. That's un millefeuille. Can you see it? Again, I'm going to take several pictures. Un millefeuille means 1,000 sheets. Un millefeuille. Millefeuille. Mille est invariable. Okay, so if you use it, never say 2,000s. 2,000 avec un S, never, ever, ever. Mille is 1,000 and that's it. We don't change it. Le millefeuille is about de la pâte feuilletée with de la crème pâtissière. So you alternate la pâte feuilletée, la crème pâtissière, la pâte feuilletée, la crème pâtissière. And that's why you're supposed to have 1,000 sheets because la pâte feuilletée is puff pastry and it expands into tiny sheets and it's so good. On this one, on this millefeuille, you have on the top, you have le glaçage on the top. Le glaçage. And again, it's just like with l'éclair au chocolat. You have something that is very sweet and looks like cake frosting. So that's really le glaçage. Le glaçage. Sometimes you have du sucre glace. Le sucre glace. And that's like that. That's le sucre glace. Okay. Today, I wanted to show you three because there's so many. And these are the main ones. There are other main ones, but these are very, very famous. La tartelette, le millefeuille, and l'éclair au chocolat. And because I wanted to buy more than just three, I bought other ones too. They're not things that you will find in every pâtisserie because each one has their specialty and they might do one and not the others. And this one is un chou chantilly. Un chou à la chantilly or chou chantilly, same. So you have la crème chantilly here. That's white. It's so good. You have une pâte à choux here and you have icing sugar, le sucre glace. But again, this one might have another name. And that's une feuilletine au chocolat. So you have du biscuit and then you have chocolate. And it's, if you could smell it, it smells so good. And again, this you might not find in the same way in another pâtisserie, but they are like classics of pâtisserie. And it depends on what pâtisserie you're going to and the day of the week, because sometimes they do it only on the weekends. It's really up to the pâtisserie, but these ones you will find all the time in a pâtisserie. Easy to find. Also, what I wanted to mention today, which is extremely important because this is a question I get all the time, is for these two especially, it's like for the bread. We don't know the names of all the pâtisserie. I would not know how to name those, like the true name from the pâtisserie, because it's like a brand for a pâtisserie. And it's the same for the bread. We don't know the names of all of them. You just go to la boulangerie, if you go and you pick, you just show or say the name of the bread that you can read on the little label and take that one. So it doesn't make any sense to know the names of all the pâtisserie as much as it doesn't make any sense to know the names of all the breads. Unless you are a pâtisserie chef, obviously, but that's a completely different story. The local pâtisserie I took is Le Chardon Bleu. I'm not making any advertisement for them because they're already very famous in Grenoble. It's where I get my bread every day. And it comes, so the pâtisserie come in a little box, and this is what you will find everywhere. So it's like cardboard box. This one is very pretty, I think. And this one is just for solo pâtisserie. So I bought this one in that because it was too high. But these other ones came in the box. And that's very, very simple. And all of them come this way. So this is how they're usually offered. So let's test yourself. How do you call that one? That one is easy because it's so famous. That's un éclair au chocolat, okay? Super simple. Un éclair au chocolat. This one is un millefeuille. Un millefeuille. 1,000 sheet. And at last, the third one is this one. It's une... Ooh, I hope it doesn't fall. Une tartelette au citron. Une tartelette au citron. And you can have tartelette with anything. Remember that we add et at the end of a word to make it sound smaller. So une tarte becomes une tartelette when it's a small pie. Et toi, partage une anecdote ou un conseil à propos des pâtisseries. Share an anecdote or a piece of advice about pâtisserie. For example, quand je suis en France, j'aime bien m'acheter une pâtisserie pour le goûter et la manger sur un banc dans un jardin public. Quand je suis en France, j'aime bien m'acheter une pâtisserie pour le goûter et la manger sur un banc dans un jardin public. Oh, it smells so good. It smells delicious here. Also, if you have une pâtisserie that you love, please share its name and its address, possibly in the comment area, so we can enrich it and students can maybe visit it with your recommendation. As usual as well, if you have questions or comments about this lesson, please share it. I answer all the comments and I love hearing from students. And when I answer, I can share the answer with all the other students, so it makes the lesson even more valuable for everybody. So don't be afraid and ask. If you want to go beyond this lesson, check out my free 10-day everyday French crash course. It's a mini course by email. How can you get it? You go to communefrancaise.com and leave your first name and email, and you will get lesson one immediately. You can also unsubscribe anytime if it doesn't suit you. Join us, it's lots of fun, and it's a free 10-day everyday French crash course. So it's a lot of fun together, and you will double your Frenchness in just 10 days, make your French sound more modern and fluent. If you learned something today, please help me spread the word about Commune Française. We don't always talk about pâtisserie, but this is a very good topic, so I might do more of those. Share this lesson with a Francophile friend. You can do that on email, you can text your friend, you can tell them in real life, call them as well. And even better, share this lesson with a French class. Maybe they want to hear about those delicious pâtisseries too. Merci for taking the time to watch this Commune Française lesson. I highly appreciate it. I love sharing my culture and my language and all these delicious things. More and more students are learning French with me and I love teaching it. I hope to see you next Tuesday, à mardi prochain, à la semaine prochaine. In the meanwhile, I will share that with my friends. À la prochaine fois. Allez, salut et bon appétit!